Hi friends. Today is the last day at work, so this is the last time you'll see this background, and I'm going to be doing something else in the future. And that is scary and exciting. But both at the same time. And I don't know, I was not really sure how that is making me feel. I think it's definitely a little bit scary. Starting something new, making a big change, that's always scary. At the same time, it's so exciting, it's so liberating to be going off and doing something totally different, so totally new. There's always fear that some things that we got used to, some things that are important to us, will disappear, will no longer be available to us as things change and as the future ends up being different than the past. And there may be some things that we don't know how to do when things are different, like this this blog. I'm doing it here on my work laptop with my work webcam. That'll be different. But what we often forget, I think, is all the new things that will be amazing, that will add value to our lives, that will make things even better. When we go through transitions in our lives, some things will stay the same, and some things will be different. And I think it's easy to think that. I think Venkat Rao talks about this on his blog, Ribbon Farm. He says there's kind of two fallacies that people fall into, which is, one is the arrival paradox, which is that you think when you achieve something, when something changes, then everything changes, which is almost never true. There's some things may change, but other things will stay the same. And then the other paradox that people have, or kind of the mistake fallacy that people make, is the no change fallacy, which is, oh, this might change, but nothing else will change. Everything will stay the same. And that's also not true. Everything is always changing. Everything is always changing. Even when things stay the same, things are changing a little bit. And so, yeah, things are changing a little bit, a lot in some ways. In other ways, things aren't changing at all. So. I don't know. I guess I have some comfort in that. I have some comfort in the fact that I feel like I have a certain equanimity towards change. I'm comfortable with it, and I look forward to it. I think I need change also to satisfy my curiosity, and yeah, just to feel alive. I feel really alive when things change. I need that. I need things to change. So yeah. But then of course I also need things to stay the same. It's Tony Robbins says two of the most basic human needs are the need for variety and the need for certainty. And those seem kind of like the opposite, but we just need a little bit of both. We need the variety, we need some things to change, and we need stability, we need certainty, we need some things to be the same over time. So yeah. And I think we look for those things in different ways. Maybe there is a certain stability that we can find in ourselves, so that even if everything around us changes, we still feel that there's certainty because there's a stability within us. On the other hand, maybe the opposite is also true. Maybe it's possible to have everything around you change and still feel that variety need being met because of the variety in our own minds. So I don't know. I feel like I've been rambling, but that's it. That's the nature of this blog. I'm just going to talk at the camera for a couple of minutes, and that's it for today. So, well, feel free to comment. What does change mean to you? And I'll see you tomorrow. Ciao.